Bismillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. My dear wonderful souls, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is your brother Abdussalam Abu Hanifa. So many of us would love greatly that in the day of Qiyamah we face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the minimum number possible of bad deeds. We all would love on the day of Al-Qiyamah, where we are going to read our book of actions line by line, word by word, and only goodies in it. After all, who would want to read something like backbiting, encouraged a bid'ah, fought against the true knowledge? Well, nobody would want that. Well, there are a lot of people actually that are putting themselves into a very difficult situation without them paying attention. In this pep talk here, I'm going to talk about the rumors and the news spreading through emails or social networks like Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and also WhatsApp, Messenger, and this and that. In an authentic hadith reported by Muslim radiallahu anhu, in his Sahih, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ كَذِبًا أَن يُحَدِّثَ بِكُلِّ مَا سَمِعَ. It is enough for a person to be labeled as a liar for just reporting all that they hear, and this is for man or a woman. And this is, my dear sisters and my dear brothers, as the Imam al-Nawawi alayhi rahmatullah says in Sahih Muslim, that this matter here doesn't necessarily mean that you must know it is a lie. Even if you didn't know it is a lie and you reported it, then it will be counted against you. How does that going to work out for us? Meaning, as in Sahih al-Bukhari, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَرِهَ لَكُمْ قِيلَ وَقَالَ. This is part of a big hadith in which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, certainly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala كَرِهَ, dislikes and hates. The here say, قِيلَ is what has been said to you, قَالَ is what you say to other people. Meaning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes. And when Allah dislikes something, it also means it's haram. So what is this going on, my sisters, is that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees the Muslim whose purpose in this life is much higher than being a bridge between two people, they hear right and they deliver left, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala despises that act, and on the day of Al-Qiyamah that is not going to look good on your records. Let me tell you about the day of Al-Qiyamah, what is awaiting us. When you wake up from the grave, the sounding of the trumpet has been made and we all raise completely naked. What's gonna happen at that moment there? You will notice as soon as you come out of your grave, load something, and the angels will instruct you. You are going to carry that load on your shoulders. On the day of Al-Qiyam, my dear brothers and my sisters, the actions that you have done will be in two ways. First, have a physical body, and two, the book in which they are written. This means, my sisters and my brothers, when we go to face Allah, when we go to the auditing, you will come with what? With the book and the actions. You will put your actions and then you open your book and you start reading. Walayyadu billah, what a horrible picture. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Al-Quran, in Surah Al-Ankabut, the spider, he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is ayah number 13, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولا يحملن أثقالهم وأثقالا مع أثقالهم ولا يسألن يوم القيامة عما كانوا يفترون. أعوذ بالله. In the meaning of the ayah, and they will surely carry their own burdens, i.e. the outcomes of their actions, your deeds, and others' burden along with them, and they shall surely be questioned about all the standings when they stand in front of Allah, about all the lies that they used to promote, share with other people. What this means, my brothers and my sisters, when you come out of the grave, you will find the first load, these are your actions, and then the other surprise comes, you will find another load, and the other load is also yours to carry. On the day of Al-Qiyamah, Al-Hasanat, the good deeds will be light. They will be light to carry. The evil deeds will be extremely heavy. But when you put your actions in al-mizan, in the balance, the good deeds will turn extremely heavy, and the bad deeds will also be heavy, but it will be according to how you behaved in this dunya. In another surah, in Surah An-Nahl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in ayah number 25, لِيَحْمِلُوا أَوْزَارَهُمْ كَامِلَةً يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَمِنْ أَوْزَارِ الَّذِينَ يُضِلُّونَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ أَلَا سَاءَ مَا يَزِرُونَ. So Allah says that on the day of Al-Qiyamah, they will carry their own sins in full. All the sins that they have made, they will carry them in full. And not only that, but they will also carry the sins and the burden of the sins for other people that they misguided without knowledge. Certainly, it will be a heavy, wal-iyadu billah, bad thing that they shall carry. What's all this? It means, as it says in Surah Yasin, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى وَنَكْتُبُ مَا قَدَّمُوا وَآثَارَهُمْ وَكُلَّ شَيْءٍ أَحْصَيْنَاهُ فِي إِمَامٍ مُبِينٍ. On the day of Qiyamah, my dear brothers and my dear sisters, any act that you have done, as Rasulullah ﷺ reported in the books of the Sunan, the Tirmidhi and Abu Dawud, and the hadith is authentic, that man sanna sunnatan hasana, whoever does a good act of sunnah and then preaches it to others, you do da'wah, then whoever practices it, you will get full reward of theirs without this affecting their reward. What this means is, if you teach somebody, for example, how to do a sunnah, how to hold your hands in salat. It's funny how people hold their hands today, but anyway. So when you teach somebody how to hold the hands properly in a salat, when they hold it, let's say they get 80% ajr, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you 100%. It will not affect their reward. Which means if you, your own hold hand in is 90%, you get your own 90% and you get the other 100. So you get 190 hasanat for just holding the hand. Now imagine if you taught 10 people. So on the day of Qiyamah, when you have done a good hasana, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala writes that in your account. Also in the sins, when you promote a sin, you will get the sin yourself. And then everyone who does the sin because of you, you will get that sin. So my dear brothers and my sisters, how does all this tie up in this today's life? You receive a text, and I do this a lot. A lot of people send me a lot of things in personally, like messages, videos, saying all this, saying all that. And they want me to post them in the group. Most of the time, what I get are calamities, lies, fabricated hadith, and evil translations from Arabic to English, and go on videos and clips. Some Muslims, before, I had to be really firm with them. They would send me clips of women. This one, and women wearing miniskirt in the name of Islam. Na'udhu billah. Some others, they sent me a young Muslim woman talking and pretty made up face, and she's talking about Allah. And here I am looking at this pretty lady here, and I tell them, ya akhi, fear Allah. If looking at women in the street is haram, it is also haram to look at them on the television. It is haram as well looking at them on the clips. What that happens is, it makes it that when I look at the clips, he will get the sins. Yes, I will get my sin, but he also will get 100% of my sins. If I learn something evil through your text and I practice it, you will get 100% of the evil. And if, how much evil? Now, let me tell you this one. You receive a message today, and that message is evil, is wrong. And then you forward it to somebody else. That somebody else will forward it to 100,000 people. I swear by Allah, you will get 100% of the 100,000 people into your account. Can you deal with that? Can you actually go back to your grave with so many sins just because you forwarded one message that you never took time to double check if it's correct or not? I received texts, people, alhamdulillah, some brothers, jazakumullah khair, they would send me something, double check this for me. And many times I send them back and say, don't promote this. And I answer back in such a way, and I ask them, please send this back to the person that sent you the message. And we have to draw back and to go back to whoever sent it until we get to the source. In another hadith, Rasulullah ﷺ gives us a very, very, very important tool that shaitan uses to get us into trouble. Rasulullah ﷺ says, as reported by Al-Albani in his chain of authentic hadith, بِئْسَ مَطِيَّةُ الرَّجُلْ زَعَمُ. Rasulullah ﷺ says, in the meaning of the general meaning of the hadith, it is, pretense is a man's evil right to speaking. What does that mean? Many times I ask people, either in my class or seminars or wherever, I ask people about what's the meaning of this. They would say, and I'm sure you're familiar with this, I don't know. And then they go, I think, and then they write an essay after it. That moment of I think, I assume, I believe, probably, maybe, all these words, they are keys to a shaitan to open the gates of ignorance reservoir, and all that is against you. So my dear brothers and my dear sisters, for the love of Allah, watch out what you say on WhatsApp. Do not become a bridge to evil. Someone sends you a message just because it sounds good that say, I'm gonna forward it. That is not good enough. That is not good enough. So what's the right attitude? When someone sends you a message, be the last one to receive that message. Stop it. Don't forward it. Yes, if it talks like this, da'wah and things like that, alhamdulillah. But those cheap messages, sometimes somebody sends me a piano as a background music, and somebody's reciting the hadith and the Quran. So now we need music, background to Quran and sunnah. It no longer is enough to say the name of Allah. We are going through difficult times, my dear brothers and my dear sisters. Ignorance has become king. Promotion of evil has become king. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you will stop being a bridge to evil. Don't build your bridge to Jahannam today by sending messages to other people through your phone. When you receive or you don't receive, put an end to it. This is why in the group I forbid anyone to post directly to the group, because if I leave it open, people would post only Allah knows what. This is again your brother Abdus Salam Abu Hanifa. My telephone number is 07876408735. This is the United Kingdom, and if you want to join the group, by all means do send me a message and I'll add you to the group. You guys have a wonderful day and be blessed. The day is yours. Don't waste it thinking about yesterday. Move forward. I love you all in Allah. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.